Good evening and welcome back to Answers on Eschatology. My name is Dan Derry and I'm the president of the Institute of Fulfilled Eschatology. Hey, welcome back to our study, The Spirit and the Restoration of Israel. And we have been demonstrating that the Holy Spirit being poured out upon the nation of Israel in the first century, specifically through the Pentecost event, was the definitive sign and proof that their messianic restoration was taking place at that time. And I want to prove this again by looking at Isaiah 44 and John chapter 7. So, go with me to Isaiah 44. Let's read verses 1 through 5. Then we'll jump over to John chapter 7, John's gospel, and we'll let John give the inspired apostolic interpretation of what Isaiah actually prophesied. Isaiah 44, 1 says this, "But now listen, O Jacob, my servant, and Israel, whom I've chosen. Thus says the Lord, who made you and formed you from the womb, who will help you. Do not fear, O Jacob, my servant, and Jeshurun, whom I've chosen." Now watch verse 3. "For I will pour out water on the thirsty." Now, in my Bible, they have the thirsty land, but land's in italics, which means it's not in the original. It literally says, "I will pour out water on him who thirsts." Are you with me? Now watch this. "And streams on the dry ground. I will pour out my spirit on your offspring and my blessings on your descendants." What we have in verse 3 is a Hebrew parallelism. The last two lines interpret the first two lines. So the water that's poured out is the spirit that's poured out. And the thirsty, those who thirst, are the offspring and the descendants of Israel. So this prophecy concerns the pouring out of the spirit upon Israel. And here's the result, verse 4. "They will spring up among the trees," the grass, "like poplars by streams of water. This one will say, I am the Lord's, and that one will call in the name of Jacob, and another one will write on his hand, belonging to the Lord, and will name Israel's name with honor." This is restoration imagery. Israel is being restored when the Spirit was poured out as water upon him who was thirsty. Go with me to John 7, and let's let the Apostle John interpret Jesus' words according to Isaiah 44. Now watch this. Verse 37 of John 7 says this, "Now on the last day, the great day of the feast, Jesus stood and cried out, saying, if anyone thirsts," what did Isaiah say? I will pour out my spirit like water on him who thirsts." Jesus is alluding to Isaiah 44. But watch this. "Let him come to me and drink." So Jesus says, if anyone's thirsty, by the way, this is a thirst for righteousness. Matthew 5 verse 6. And Jesus is satisfying that thirst for righteousness. He says, if anyone thirsts, come to me. He who believes in me, as the scripture says, from his innermost being will flow rivers of living water. But this, now John gives us the interpretation of what Jesus was talking about. But this he spoke of the Spirit, whom those who believe in him were to receive, for the Spirit was not yet given because Jesus was not yet glorified. So John interprets Jesus to say, if anyone's thirsty, come to me and receive the Spirit. What did Isaiah say? The Spirit would be given to him who thirsts. This, in John 7, is the fulfillment of Isaiah 44. But, according to John, this Spirit will be given to those who thirst in fulfillment of Isaiah 44. When? When the Spirit was poured out. When the Spirit was given after Jesus had been glorified. Well, when was that? That was the day of Pentecost, when the Spirit was poured out as water upon the nation of Israel in fulfillment of Isaiah 44. That means the day of Pentecost, when Israel received the Spirit was poured out upon the righteous, and they were satisfied. And Israel's messianic restoration was taking place in fulfillment of Isaiah 44. That's powerful stuff. That means Israel's restoration was not political. It was not geocentric. It wasn't about physical restoration to a Mosaic economy. It was restoration to the new covenant in Jesus Christ by the Spirit. And that took place the day of Pentecost in AD 30. We'll see you next time on Answers on Eschatology. And we'll pick it up once again on the day of Pentecost. And we'll look at verse 38, specifically of John 7, where out of their innermost beings would flow rivers of living water. And that too would be by the Spirit. We'll see you next time. Bye for now.